Hello students, till today we have seen a design of gear means all four gears, spur, helical, bevel, worm gears, that we have seen the design of all the gears. Then we have seen the design of IC engine component, in which we have seen the cylinder, cylinder head design, piston design, crank, connecting rod, crankshaft, valve design. So all the things almost we have seen for the design of IC engine component. Then we have seen the design of bearing, different types of bearing like rolling contact bearing, journal bearing. So all that we have seen. After that, today we are going to start a new chapter and name is design of cranes. So the first introduction of design of crane is to material handling. Okay, so if we talk about material handling, by three way we can handle the three way. First is picking the load, then transporting the load, means the load pick from one place, we have to transfer the load and just pull over here, means load down over here. So this is a basic process for the material handling: picking, transporting, and again unloading, right? So basically, in general, material handling cost range from 10% to 35% of the cost of the product. So it is very important to have cost optimization and time optimization for material handling system. Now the system concept for the material handling. So the solution of material handling problem justify the following condition. So this condition is required for it should be justified, okay, satisfied. Now what is the first? So the solution of material handling problem should not transfer the problem into other area. Suppose you have decided some material handling things from one area, then you cannot apply the same thing in another area, right? Second is, the solution should not only resolve the immediate problem. Okay, we do not have to see the instant, instant problem, remove the instantly, but we also think about the future, right? What in the for the long time. So it should be able to account for the future expansion or modification without unreasonable cost, right? Next is, okay, so just a second please. Next is, the solution should not be prone to rapid obsolescence. It means it should not be outdated. So we have to use, we have to use the advanced thing for the material handling system. Then the solution should be as simple as and easy to adopt. Then solution should be such that the initial cost as well operation cost should be minimum. So all these things, it is very easy to know and understand, right? So types of load handled by the material handling system. So there are two types. First one is bulk load and second one is unit load. So let us understand what is the bulk load and what is the unit load. So bulk load, it means it consists a larger number of homogeneous particle or lumps or any material like coal, mineral or sand, stone, clay. You can understand these things, right? So second is unit load, yani ki here you can say machine, box, container, which we can pick up from one place to another place. Okay, so we can pick up and drop these things. We cannot do like the same thing, material handling with the same thing, coal, mineral ore and sandstone, all that. Now second is containerization. Containerization means the process of converting the bulk load or the small unit into a load by the using container, unit load. Okay, so we have to convert it into the unit load which can fill into the container, is known as a containerization. Okay, so it is simple thing. Now next is material handling equipment and guidelines in selection. So material handling equipment are used for moving the load factory. All this, you know, when if you read this, even if you read this, you will know about this, right? So here I am just giving the overview, so we are going fast. So here the material handling equipment is at the center. Then we have to see the location, direction, distance, purpose and move. So if we talk about the location, then it should be the factories or plants, construction sites, then mines, ports, storage. Okay, so all these things we have to take into the consideration. Then direction, material handling direction will be the vertical, horizontal or inclined. Then distance, okay, so 10 hundreds of meters, you know, the distance is also matter for the material handling system. If we have to select the proper material handling equipment, then distance is also matter. Then purpose, so the purpose means the constant load transfer, or we have to, you know, load transfer unit by unit like that. And move, bulk or unit loads, right? So all these things we should know when we design something about the material handling equipment and guideline. Okay, now the principle means all these things we have discussed: the direction of the load travel, the length of the load travel, type and properties of the load handle, required load moving capacity or unit, of unit, characteristics of production process. Okay, there is a mass production, there is a job production. So method of stacking load at the initial and final point, usko kaise pick up karna hai, kaise unload karna hai, load condition, what will be the load condition, initial and operational cost, all these things we have to consider for the selecting the material handling equipment, right? So if you know these 8 things, you can write yourself. Okay, so I do not repeat all these things individually. Okay, these lines I'm not going to read all the things, you just read and understand, you can understand easily, right? So here, after that, here you can see May 2015, what are the factors to be considered while selecting material handling equipment, already asked in GTU exam. What are the basic principle for the selecting the material handling equipment? So it is very important thing for you, so you guys must remember all these 8 things and describe it properly. Okay, now what is the objective of material handling system? So this is also important. What is the objective? So accuracy in transporting load to destination, so accuracy should be there. Okay, so precision in pickup of load, because there are so many things that we should take care to pick up. Okay, so if there is a problem created over there, then the whole workpiece, or we can say the product, will be lost. Then transporting load in a scheduled time. Okay, timing is also important. Transporting load at required quantity is also important. Transporting load without damage, it's very very important. Automation with the minimum manpower. Okay, we have to use the hoist, crane and all that, and so with the minimum manpower we can handle a large amount of material. Okay, low initial and operational cost, simplicity and easy maintenance, operational safety. So all the things are comes into the objective of material handling system. So friends, I mean to say, you can read it. Okay, so you can read it and understand it. The things is, you have to remember all this main topic. Okay, like 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Okay, so all these things you have to remember, this 9 topic, just read again and again. You have to remember this topic, and I know that you can write on individual topic yourself, right? Now next is classification of material handling equipment. So here if you see, there are 3 main things, that is the hoisting equipment, then conveyors and surface overhead equipments. So if we talk about the hoisting equipments, then we have hoisting machine, cranes and elevators. And if we talk about particular machines, then it come there are so many things come in this: jacks, pulleys, portable hand hoist, portable power operated hoist, then travel power operated hoist, okay, winches, all that. एंड लाइक क्रैन, जीप क्रैन, जीप क्रैन विथ रोटरी पिलर, टेलीस्कोपिक टावर क्रैन, ईओटी क्रैन, गैंट्री क्रैन. सो ऑल दिस थिंग्स कम इन टू द क्रैन. एंड एलिवेटर लाइक केज एलिवेटर, वर्टिकल स्किप एलिवेटर, मैन्युअली प्रोपेल्ड स्टैकर्स. सो ऑल दिस थिंग्स कम्स इन टू द एलिवेटर, राइट. सेम थिंग हियर, इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द कन्वेयर, देन इट फ्लैट बेल्ट, थ्रू बेल्ट, ओके, सो ब्लैंकेट बेल्ट कन्वेयर, चेन कन्वेयर, अपॉन कन्वेयर. So all these things. So mainly we have here three things, that is hoisting, conveyor and surface and overhead equipment, right? So overhead equipment, you can see here there are three things in overhead equipments. So we will discuss about this in a later next lecture. Okay, so today I think this is enough. Okay, thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat. See you soon.